How's it going, everybody? This is Beat the Bush. Have you ever thought about what would happen if everybody invested in index funds? If this happens and it's getting there, then investing in an index fund is not as diversified as you think. It would just kind of be the whole market is investing in one giant stock. But before I get to this, let me give a shout out to the car seats review video I did on my other channel. My other channel is called Beat the Bush DIY, and I'll leave the video over here. Now over there, I review some car seats cover, and it's getting weirder and weirder because I just basically review everything that comes my way. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to my channel down below if you have not already, and click that notification bell icon next to the subscribe button so you get notifications whenever I upload a brand new video. Did you know that out of all stock market assets, 30% are actually passive funds? These are the non-active ones where they just kind of index to a certain number of stocks. According to Moody's, by 2024, which is in just 6 short years, 50% of all assets on the stock market are going to be passively traded. It does seem that the S&P 500 ETF funds such as the VOO or various other index funds of other indexes are in vogue right now. It's been getting more and more popular, and people just go, oh yeah, these funds, you know, you really should not get actively traded funds because the fees are high. So everyone's piling into these low-cost ETF funds. Now, if you're piling it in, you're just buying this index fund, you're like, oh yeah, that's the index. But do you know what the 500 companies actually are? I know I personally only know like a handful of them. And based on my experience, I look down maybe 10, 20 of them and I get bored already. I'm sure many people don't know all 500 companies that are inside the S&P 500. Now, what does this mean for the average investor? For all the people holding these funds, it's gonna be all kinds of people from all walks of life, and they're not all going to be very clear-minded whenever there's a market downturn. I assume the mixture of people that would sell on a downturn versus the people that would hold no matter what is roughly the same as the broader market. Whenever people buy and sell, they're going to buy and sell the ETF fund itself. So then the market is gonna all float up and down together. With everyone piling into these ETF funds, what's gonna happen is that the volatility is gonna be greater for all those stocks that's included in that index. A stock that is included in an index generally on average has a higher valuation than a stock that is not. You see this a lot whenever a stock gets added to an index, the price jumps on average by 9%. There's a positive effect when it gets added to the index, but there's also a negative effect. In October 1987, index stocks generally dropped 7% more than non-index stocks. So you'll see in the next crash or any kind of perturbation that with all these people buying into ETF funds and with it being more and more popular, the volatility is gonna go up, and you're gonna see that index stocks is gonna take a harder hit whenever something bad does happen. There's also a dark side to these ETF funds because some people have noticed that some companies might be buying ETF funds a big chunk of it at the same time. So what they end up doing is they go in right before they do the buy, and right after they buy, they sell it. So in effect, it's kind of like scooping up a little bit of value right before they buy it, which causes the price to go up, and after it goes up, then they go and sell it. Of course, people caught on really quickly, and so whenever they do these big buys of the ETF funds, they're gonna do a little bit of scattering these days so that people can't try to time it right before they buy. So let's think about this. If you're buying an ETF fund in the S&P 500, is this really diversification if everyone is buying the same ETF? If you are concerned, you can most certainly buy the total index fund, which covers a lot more stocks other than the 500 in the S&P 500. All of this was on my mind early on when I heard about people buying ETF funds in the S&P 500 for the fifth or sixth time. I'm like, wait a minute. If it's getting so popular, then it's kind of counterintuitive here. It's counteracting itself when everyone is doing the same thing. I hope you enjoyed this way of thinking and kind of get your mind thinking about what the consequences are if everyone actually piled in. Don't forget to give me a like on this video, comment down below. Let me know what you think of ETF funds that everyone else is also buying. If you're interested in supporting my channel, don't forget to check out my Audible link down in the video description below, where you can get an audiobook of your choice. And if you don't like the audiobook or the service, you can cancel it before the trial period ends, and you can still keep the book and help benefit this channel as well. If you're interested in supporting my channel, I have a Patreon link over here where I give various perks at various contribution levels. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel over here and click that bell icon next to the subscribe button so you get notification whenever I upload a brand new video. Thanks for watching.